My patient is Kara Smith. She's a 17-year-old cystic fibrosis patient. She came to the ER after spending a long day in the sun yesterday, showing severe signs of dehydration, and she is on a high-protein, high-calories, and high-salt diet. Before I go in to see my patient, I'm going to review doctor's orders, and I will wash my hands. Knock, knock, knock. Hi, privacy. Hello, my name is Sarah. I'm going to be your nurse today. Can I get your name and date of birth? Perfect. I'm going to start off by getting some vital signs for you, and I'm going to listen to your heart and your lung sounds and your belly sounds. I've heard you're having some constipation due to that cystic fibrosis. First, I'm going to take your blood pressure. I'm going to take a listen to your lungs. Just breathe normal for me. All right, let's have you lean forward for me. Have you take a deep breath for me. Good. Sure. So I'm going to have you open your mouth up and lift your tongue up, and I'm just going to rest it in there. Now I'm going to take a listen to your stomach. Look, there is abdominal distension. Right, then I would listen. I'm going to finish up the vital signs. I'm going to check your pulse and respirations. While we're doing that, I'm just going to slide this onto your finger. Okay. So I'm all finished getting my assessment done. I'm going to go document everything I found, let the doctor know, and see what he wants us to order and have us do. Is there anything I can do for you while I'm still in here? All right, here's your call light, and let us know if you need anything. So upon assessment, I found that my patient's blood pressure was 98 over 72. Respirations are 21 with rapid, shallow breaths, with wheezes located throughout the lung field, and coughing with deep breathing. Her O2 saturations were 92% and her pulse was 98. Orders. I'm gonna go see my patient. Knock, knock, knock. All right, so I have your medications for you. Can I get your name and date of birth? All right, and then do you have any allergies to medication? No. All right, so I have for you today sodium chloride, which is gonna help raise your blood pressure from all that sweat loss. And with your cystic fibrosis, you have excessive cell loss, and so we're gonna replenish some of that. I also have a stool softener for, because of your constipation, this is gonna help try and get things moving a little easier for you. And on their medication. And we've got a few things started for you, but I see that your O2 sats are pretty low, so I'm going to start out by raising the head of the bed. And you would like us to start some oxygen via nasal cannula. So I'm going to get them into high fowlers. Okay, to help with those wheezes and to help you breathe, he ordered a nebulizer treatment. So this is just gonna go over your face and it's gonna just help you breathe and make things a little easier on you. I came in 30 minutes later to check on my patient. I readed vital signs. Patient tolerated interventions well. O2 sats are up and patient is happy. I would document my patient had a low blood pressure from a lot of sweat loss yesterday from being out in the sun, and with cystic fibrosis, they have a lot of salt excretion through their skin, which also caused the blood pressure to drop. I heard wheezes located in the lungs, which is also caused by mucus production in the lungs, and that's the nature of the cystic fibrosis. And she had hypoactive bowel sounds, which is also caused by the thick mucus lining the intestines, which doesn't allow peristalsis to move correctly. Because of the nature of cystic fibrosis, we encouraged the patient to have a high-calorie, high-protein diet to replenish a lot of those nutrients that they aren't absorbing. So we would encourage like nuts, high-protein like red meats, and like avocado and things like that.